And now it's time for the extreme edge.
See this right here? Shaking in front of your face? That's what the smallmouth are going to see on this segment right here. It's September, freezing cold morning, 1 degree, I kid you not. But you still want to go fishing. You know you're going to catch fish. How you want to do it? Well, I like still power fishing, but I want to use something that the fish see and eat. So the catfish shad this morning will do it for me. Look at this day. It's beautiful outside. Sunny, low wind, a little chilly, but that's the deal. This time of year, the fish want to eat. Well, bigger fish do come in from some of those summer haunts. And there's an opportunity, a window, when they come in nice and tight, I'd say 6 to 7, 8 feet. Sometimes the shallow is 4 feet of water, depending on the lake you're fishing, the water clarity. But today it's going to be that little caffeine shad. That's the 4-inch. I'm going to throw it on the Mojo Bass 6-8 medium power. And I got it with the little Daiwa Tatula reel. 14-pound gamma edge, okay? So I don't want to go too heavy in the line. Otherwise, this takes a bit more time to sink. So the 14 is just perfect with the 4-inch bait. It falls slow. I make little slow sweeping rod twitches underneath. Slow to go, slow to go. And then all of a sudden, you can see a toilet flush. The line goes dink, or the rod in your wrist goes dunk, like lightning. That's when the excitement happens. So let me show you how I rig up, where I fish, how I fish, so you can do it too. What's very important is you dissect that water in front of you. Try not to make those real long bomb casts. Unless you're using straight braid with a leader, I'm using straight fluorocarbon, so there is some stretch. So you really got to pick up that slack line, lean back, and really make sure you got that hook set, because you got to get that one single hook. Yeah, it's sharp, and yes, it's right, and yes, it's soft plastics, but you still got to get it, because these smallmouth are eating this thing. They're not just smacking it, they're eating it. So they're clamping down that mouth. They don't want to let it go. And their mouth is like a pit bull. The jaw pressure is incredible. So you got to make sure that that metal meets the meat. Look right there. Yeah. Just finished saying, eh? Good smallmouth too. Right on this edge. Let it sink. And he slammed it. On the edge of 8-foot weed. Look at that little caffeine shad, man. Come here, boy. Oh yeah. Nice way to start a nice September morning, eh? With fog, you name it. Look where it's got it too. Look at that, right there. Right to the side. Take a few pictures, a few fish. Decent smallmouth to start my foggy, cold September morning. Like, it was zero this morning. Zero. Yeah. And see what still bites? Because they want to eat. There's a period in fall, I'll explain it, where they want to come in to eat. Right now, we'll put them in the box. Let's catch some more. This is exactly what I'm talking about right here. Some pads, submerged cabbage, 7 feet of water. Stay back, make my casts. Remember, those fall smallmouth come back and forth in this stuff all day to feed. So I got milk runs. I put the waypoints on the garment and I just dissect these little spots of submerged cabbage from 6 to 8 feet of water. And it's so important in fall just to have confidence in the bait you're using. The caffeine shad, I know that when I find bass and they see it, they'll take a shot at it. Okay, third spot, rocky point. Now we all know the rocks always attract heat, attract bait fish, attract smallmouth, especially in September on cold days. Now, I'm gonna fish down in front of the point where the boulders are going up, where it's tapering, and then off the point. I don't wanna run right to the point and then fish those edge of the boulders and stuff. I'd rather work the tapering edge in case there's fish in the shallow water going up along the rocks, then towards the point. So the point comes out, I'll either fish coming up from the right-hand side or go past the point on the left-hand side, come back down and fish it. Then eventually cast right up tight to the point, but let the caffeine shad just fall a bit, a few twitches, and hope to get bit. Toilet flush, look at that. What are you? Nice smallmouth, just a decent fish. I let that fish just take it. He toilet flushed it, I made sure he had it. Took my time, hey, There you are. That's exactly how it's done, man. Exactly how it's done. Slow and methodical with a caffeine shad. Take your time. Slow and to go. 4-inch little shad bait. Nice little smallmouth. We'll let him go. Look at that. That's what you get. Northern Ontario right there in September on cold mornings. The shad bait. Let's let him go right here. Hey, you ready to go? Huh? Ready? Come on. Wow. And that's how we do it. Slow, twitch, twitch. And when you get on spots, either weed or thick weeds or rock points like this and stuff, you can inspire those fish to come up. How deep am I fishing? I'm in 12 feet. A lot of times those fish are suspended 5-6 feet down. But when this lands, they know it lands. Spish, twitch, twitch, toilet flush. The best part is when they grab it, with all that coffee scent, they're not gonna spit it out. I put a few more sprays on it and stuff, just so they hold it. Think of the caffeine shad, soft little sweeps in September when you wanna catch them. When it's cool out and everyone else is drop shotting in deep water, you know those smallmouth still go shallow.